Hey, welcome back to Bridal Sewing Techniques, and today we're going to talk about how to pack a gown, specifically to retain its shape during shipping or storage. Are you someone who has experience with a mix of sewing, but is looking to get into the bridal niche? This channel is for you. Today's video, I'm doing by request. I'm sorry, I can't specifically remember who it was that asked me, but someone said they would love to learn how to use the cardboard dress forms like you see from dry cleaners, and then also just some other ideas of the ideal way to pack a gown for shipping or storage so that the bust does not get misshapen. So that's what today's video is all about. But looky here, I just wanted to give a shout out to our BST bestie, Pam Overstreet. You'll see her name sometimes in the comments. She's a real sweetheart. She sent me this book. That was sweet of her. Today I'm going to show you two different ways specifically to pack a gown. This first one, we're going to do a little reverse engineering. This gown just came back from one of my favorite cleaners. When I have to ship something way off for dry cleaning, it goes out to Aero Cleaners in Missouri, and they do a fabulous job on our tricky dresses. So this has come back from them, and like I said, I don't use these cardboard dress forms in the shop, so I wanted to show you what one of the finer dry cleaners in this country would do to pack a gown. So as you saw, it was wrapped in plastic. I always take that off so the gown can kind of gas out. You can see they drew up the hang loops just a little bit to try to pull the dress up a little bit higher on the form. And we're going to look at this configuration very closely just to see how they did it and to see how they put this cardboard piece together. So there's all the plastic I pulled off. Plastic can turn sequins a little yellow or something like that. As you can see, this is hanging a little low on the cardboard bust. This is one of the reasons why I don't personally prefer a cardboard bust. Okay, and so this is how it was assembled to be put on the hanger. They stapled these pieces together to form the bust angle, and this is put on a traditional metal hanger. I don't use those in my shop. I use the kind that have the notches on the shoulders and have the swivel head, but this is the kind, of course, that dry cleaners use. So they stapled that, and then as you saw, they hung the hang loops on the little shoulder notches, and this is where they get that shape from. All right, so this is how I start when I am going to pack a gown. You can see that the waistline, if you have it level, the dress hangs a lot better. So you could either add extra hang loops to the front and back, or you can pack the gown the way that we do it in the shop sometimes when we need to do this. Now, I have been in the back room, the shipping room of some very high-end bridal salons in this country. Here I'm gesturing for the supplies. We need some acid-free tissue paper and some 1/4 inch ribbon. Go ahead and just pull off a lot of that. Just do, you know, I don't know, 2 or 3 yards of it. If you need more, you can tie to it and make more. But I'm letting you see the details of how I tie this through. I've doubled this hanger too. You can see I've got two hangers taped together because this is a very heavy dress. But anyways, back to the thing about the bridal salons, I've actually been super blessed to be in the back room of some of the United States' finest bridal salons, and I've actually been able to see them pack dresses for shipment. So I've seen them in the back at Kleinfeld's packing dresses, and also there are some times that we have dresses delivered to our shop from Kleinfeld's. Because the bride bought it there, and then for some reason, you know, they're coming to us for the alterations. So I've seen both ways. I've seen it going out from there, and then also how it arrives at a salon. And this is personally just gleaning the information that I've had from many of these bridal salons. This is my favorite way to pack a dress. So you can see I'm just making a very large bow tie with many layers of the acid-free tissue paper, and I'm tying it around there, and I'm leaving this long tail to this ribbon so I can keep doing it. I'm going to do it several times, and what we're going to do is, you know, you saw how I spread it apart, make it like a big pom-pom, and shove it down in there, and you just want to really pack that dress super densely so that it can retain its shape. Now, back to the way that the dresses arrive, say from Kleinfeld or another high-end bridal salon, they're usually boxed pretty tightly. So they come in a large box, not a wedding gown preservation box, but more like a corrugated shipping container, cardboard box. So we open that, and the dress is usually wrapped in plastic, just like that dress that came from Aero Cleaners. And it is sunk down in the box, and it fits perfectly in the box, so it has not been moving around in shipment. And then when we pull it out, the dress has been physically packed with something to retain the shape of the bodice. And then usually they take the hang loop from the underside of the train, and that's also hooked up at the top of the hanger. Now, one very, very high-end way of shipping, this is amazing, is when they ship them upright. Sometimes you'll see a gown arrive, white glove delivery in a box, kind of like a refrigerator box. And you open the box, or it's like an armoire or something is what it looks like, but it's a corrugated container box. You open it, and the gown has been wired, the hanger is wired through a wire in the top of the box, and the gown is hanging in the box. Of course, it's still packed nicely like this, and covered. You know, it still has its gown bag and that kind of thing, but it is shipped upright, which is just amazing to be shipped hanging. So this is just a finishing touch that I put on it. You can see the slit that I put through it so that it would go through that ribbon nicely, and then I tuck the extra ribbon down. But this is just a nice little touch to the presentation. But like I said, this is pretty densely packed, so the dress is not going to get super easily crushed and misshapen while it's in storage or while it's being shipped. So another important thing to remember in storage is you always want to use an acid-free fabric gown bag. The plastic, like I said, it can turn the sequins or the stones. I have seen that many times. So if you really want to use plastic, if you're afraid of some type of moisture damage, I would say at least put it first in a fabric bag and then go ahead and put the plastic bag on the outer layer. Also, make sure that the gussets, the side gussets of the bag, are sufficient for the fullness of the gown. You don't want to put this much energy into perfecting the look of the dress and retaining the shape and then squash the skirt of the gown. Well, I hope this has helped you. Please, in the comments down below, tell me how do you pack a gown. I know you guys have other methods too. And just remember to keep it nice out there. We all do things differently. Tell me how you do it. I'd love to hear what you do. Tell me what's different, or maybe something that you saw that was new in this video, and some new ideas that this is kind of springboarding for you. Please don't forget to hit like, share, and subscribe. It means a lot to me, and it's also gonna keep YouTube recommending my videos to you. If you've already subscribed, hit the little bell, and you will be notified every time I upload a video. Take care, guys. Thank you. ¶¶